Where are you? The Earth? Okay. Then what's next? The Sun. And the Sun is in the Milky Way, our home galaxy. Good.
Then what's next?
The universe? No, 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 you are wrong. Our galaxy has its own home, a warm and peaceful family. Yeah. In the vast expanse of the universe, galaxies are not randomly distributed but often found in clusters. One such cluster is
the Local Group.
A fascinating collection of galaxies that includes our very own Milky Way. The group itself is a part of the larger Virgo supercluster, which may be a part of the even larger Laniakea supercluster, but that is a story of another time, perhaps. This celestial community provides astronomers with a rich field of study, shedding light on the complex dynamics and interactions that govern galaxies.
Are galaxies tasty?
No, the tastes of objects are following the inverse logarithmic law. As you can see, anything that is bigger than a tropical cyclone is considered not eatable.
Oh, that's disappointing.
But hold on for a second. Understanding the local group poses a significant challenge due to the immense distances and scales involved. The local group spans roughly 10 million light years, yes, 10 million light years. About 100 quintillion kilometers. One followed by 20 zeros. To give you a comparison, our galaxy spans roughly 90,000 light years, so yeah, home of galaxies must be big anyway. However, this is making it difficult to grasp the sheer enormity and the intricate gravitational forces at play. This vastness challenges astronomers to develop advanced observational techniques and theoretical models to map and comprehend the group's structure and behavior.
10000000 plus 12 zeros kilometer. Just a 70 trillion year trip by car.
Anyway, the local group is a big family of over 80 galaxies. As you can imagine, the local group is home to a variety of galaxy types, each with unique characteristics. The most prominent members are the Milky Way, the Andromeda Galaxy, and the Triangulum Galaxy. They are the top three. The Andromeda Galaxy is nearly 160,000 light-years across, just a bit less than two Milky Ways, and it contains roughly a trillion stars. The Milky Way, our home galaxy, is a barred spiral galaxy rich in stars, planets, and cosmic dust. The Triangulum Galaxy, also a spiral galaxy, is noticeably smaller than the Milky Way, just 60,000 light-years across, and is next to the Andromeda Galaxy. In fact, the two galaxies are so close to each other that it becomes unclear whether the Triangulum Galaxy is a companion of the Andromeda Galaxy. In addition to these major players, the local group contains numerous dwarf galaxies. These smaller galaxies, such as the large and small Magellanic clouds, orbit larger galaxies like the Milky Way and Andromeda. By the way, only people in the southern hemisphere can see the large and small Magellanic clouds. If you can see them,
let us know in the comments.
Back to dwarf galaxies. Despite their size, dwarf galaxies play a crucial role in understanding galactic formation and evolution. Many of them are particularly interesting, which we will talk about that later. There are two distinguishable core regions in the local group. One is around the Milky Way galaxy, surrounded by dozens of other tiny galaxies. These are called the Milky Way satellite galaxies, including the Sagittarius Dwarf Galaxy, Large Magellanic Cloud, Small Magellanic Cloud, Canis Major Dwarf Galaxy, Ursa Minor Dwarf Galaxy, Draco Dwarf Galaxy, Carina Dwarf Galaxy, Sextans Dwarf Galaxy, Sculptor Dwarf Galaxy, Fornax Dwarf Galaxy, Leo the First, Leo the Second, Ursa Major the First Dwarf Galaxy, Ursa Major the Second Dwarf Galaxy, Grus the First, Grus the Second, Tucana the Second, Hydras the First, Draco the Second, Carina the Second, Levens II, Carina the Third, Pictor the Second, Horologium the Second, and Virgo the First. Plus 20 to 30 more additional ultra-faint dwarf spheroidal galaxies.
Wow!
Among them, the Large Magellanic Cloud is the largest.
Wow!
It appears small in the night sky, but that's because it is 163,000 light-years away.
Wow!
The truth is that it is actually a huge monster compared to other dwarf galaxies.
Whoa.
In fact, it is the fifth largest galaxy in the local group, more than half the diameter of the Triangulum Galaxy. It is also the home of our 136 star cluster, or a famous massive star, our 136A1 is embedded in there. The galaxy is also ridiculously massive, like 2.5 times the mass of the Triangulum Galaxy. so massive, that there is chance that this galaxy will severely damage the structure of Milky Way after two galaxies collide in the next few billion years. Turns out that a big chunk of dark matter is within the range of Large Magellanic Cloud, but why? Don't ask me, I don't know either.
The Andromeda Galaxy is 2.5 million light-years from here. How to get there in a second?
Subscribe!
And I will do. It's for you. Please tell me in the comments, did the subscribe button light up rainbow and sparking fireworks when I said subscribe?
The Small Magellanic Cloud is the sixth largest in the local group and having less massive energetic stars than its bigger brother. The bizarre thing is that this is not one, but two galaxies, with a smaller one behind the main part of the Small Magellanic Cloud. The two parts have different stellar and gaseous chemical compositions. It might be due to a past interaction with its bigger brother that split the galaxy apart. Oh, you are asking what is the fourth largest? It is this one, NGC 3109. It is a small spiral galaxy sitting in the middle of nowhere. Another two interesting satellites of the Milky Way are the Canis Major Dwarf Galaxy and the Sagittarius Dwarf Galaxy. They are the closest galaxies to us. Well, it is better to say that these two galaxies are in the process of being eaten by Milky Way. The Andromeda Galaxy also has a bunch of satellites. Most of them are ordinary dwarf galaxies except M32. M32 is a tiny dwarf elliptical galaxy, but guess what? It holds a supermassive black hole, and it's almost half as massive as Milky Way's own black hole.
Whoa.
So what's going on here? How a tiny ball of stars 6,500 light-years wide contains such a thing? Unless it has a history. Studies show that M32
was
the third largest galaxy in the local group. Then it collided with the Andromeda Galaxy 2 billion years ago. Then only the core remained. This explained why it's so dense, because it is the leftover core of an originally big galaxy.
That's ominous. You are so evil, Andromeda.
Galaxy is not stopping to attack. After eliminating M32, its next target will be us. Perhaps the most astounding fact about the local group is the impending collision between the Milky Way and Andromeda galaxies. Astronomers have determined that these two spiral giants are on a collision course, set to merge in about 4.5 billion years. This cosmic dance will result in a spectacular event, dramatically reshaping both galaxies. The merger will create a new, larger galaxy, often referred to as Milkomeda or Milkdromeda. While the collision will be a slow process taking millions of years, it promises to be a breathtaking transformation of our galactic neighborhood. The Sun enters the red giant stage at that point too, and the merging process goes through the entire red giant period. So, where are you now?
The Kuiper Belt.
Where are you now?
The local group.
You are now...